Want to shoot RAW photos on your new iPhone, but you don't want to spend the extra $200 on a pro model? Well, this video's for you. Hey, it's me, George. Not long ago, when I was going from the iPhone 14 Pro up to a 16, I decided to not go for the pro phone, and I went for the normal iPhone 16. Because most of the pro features, I don't really need or even think about. But in my non-pro iPhone 16, there is one feature I'm missing, and that is the ability to shoot RAW photos. But I don't fancy spending the extra $200 just to get that one feature. So what if I told you there was another way? Let me introduce you to the Moment Camera app. Among many other pro camera features for filmmakers and photographers, this app also gives us the ability to shoot in a RAW photo format without using a pro iPhone. Not only that, but instead of having to spend the extra $200 on a pro model iPhone, you can pick up the Pro Camera by Moment app in the App Store for only $8.99. This app gets a lot of love from the smartphone filmmakers, and for good reason. But in my opinion, it doesn't get quite enough love from us photographers. So let's change that. So why is the ability to shoot in a RAW photo format on a non-pro iPhone even important for photographers? Well, let me explain. Here is a normal iPhone image from an iPhone 16 using the standard HEIF photo format. These files are designed for maximum efficiency and to save as much space as possible on your iPhone. So while these images might be efficient, when you try to edit them, they will quickly fall apart and leave you wanting more. Whereas with RAW photos from the Pro Camera app, you are going to see a much more flexible image that you can edit much the same as a dedicated camera's RAW file. Jumping into the basics of the Pro Camera by Moment app, there are a couple of things you kind of need to set up to make sure you're going to have a good shooting experience right off the bat. And the first feature I think you should set up is to enable the RAW photo format. Just by tapping this button at the top of the screen, you can make sure that every time you open the app to take a photo, you are already in the RAW shooting mode, and you're not going to accidentally be shooting in the standard HEIF mode. And the second feature is replacing the standard iPhone camera app with the Moment camera app on your lock screen. You can do this by customizing your lock screen, removing the standard camera app, and then replacing it with the Moment camera app. So you can start treating your Moment camera app as your default camera. And to go one step further, you can assign the Pro Camera app to the action button on your phone, so you have another way to open it up with a physical control. Now, something to bear in mind, when you're framing your shots using the Pro Camera app, the image you're seeing through the viewfinder isn't what the final RAW is going to look like in your editing software. This is much more of a preview, much like you would see on the back of a dedicated camera. If you want to have a look at the differences between the RAW and the RAW preview, you can do this by going into the photo gallery section of the app and cycling between the RAW and RAW preview to see the differences in the outputs. Along with autofocus and auto exposure, we also have the ability to manually focus and manually expose our images with much greater controls than the standard camera app you'll find on your iPhone. This way, you can be much more creative with your shots and have much more control over the final output from your iPhone camera. To manually expose our images, we have a few options available. You can either adjust your shutter speed or ISO values, or tap on the EV symbol and scroll left to right to decrease or increase your exposure. Do you see this interesting animation at the top right of your display? This is a histogram. And if you haven't seen a histogram before, this shows a graph of the tonal values of your image through the viewfinder, from black on the far left to white on the right. And the height of the graph at each point represents the relative number of pixels in the image with that particular tone or brightness level. If you don't see the histogram on your display by default, you'll have to go into the menu and enable it. Along with the histogram, we also have access to zebras for both highlights and shadows. In the menu, you'll find these referred to as highlight clipping and shadow clipping. When you have highlight clipping enabled, you will see all of the overexposed areas of the images being highlighted using red zebras. This way you can control your exposure to bring it down, not overexpose your highlights. Likewise, when we have shadow clipping enabled, you will see the underexposed areas of your images highlighted using blue zebras, and you can use these the same way to perfectly expose your image. Whether you want to have one or both of these zebra modes enabled, these will help you in balancing your exposure, especially in those high dynamic range images. And if you're dealing with extremely high dynamic range scenes, we also have bracketing available. With bracketing enabled in the menu and in the viewfinder, every time you shoot an image, you will actually see three files produced in the gallery. One exposed for the shadows, one exposed for the midtones, and one exposed for the highlights. And then you can combine all three of these images in your editing software to create an HDR image. This is a very good way to capture nice high dynamic range scenes, but be careful because every single time you take a shot, you'll be storing three files, and RAW files are quite big. So only turn it on when you actually need it, otherwise you might fill up your phone. We have similar tools available for manually focusing our images as well to create those pleasing out of focus backgrounds. Under the same menu, we can enable peaking for manual focus and choose a color for the peaking display. With this enabled, we can manually focus by simply tapping on the Auto F symbol and then scrolling left to right to focus further or closer to the camera. My favorite way to manually focus using the iPhone 16 is actually using the camera control function. I find the camera control function makes it feel much more like focusing using a dedicated camera. And we can also use the camera control to adjust our shutter speed, ISO, exposure, focus, and white balance. And you can cycle between any of these settings by double tapping and then scrolling between. Another unique feature of the Pro Camera app is the integration with Moment's M and T series lenses, which you can attach to your phone using your specific model's camera case, like I have here with the 58mm T-series lens on my iPhone 16. Inside the app, we can tap on this icon here and select our lens for the app to recognize. You'll then see the viewfinder sort of calibrate to the optics of your lens. With this enabled, we then have a RAW photo format with next level optics on our phone. And then when you combine this with manual focusing, it feels much more like using a dedicated camera. You can choose from a range of focal lengths on the Moment store, and you can attach these very simply using the camera case for your specific phone model. With one of these lenses attached to your phone, you completely change the shooting experience when using your iPhone. The 58mm field of view is just that little bit tighter than the standard 2x zoom of the iPhone 16, which gives us a 48mm field of view. Then when you manually focus using these lenses, the depth of field feels much more dramatic, especially when you increase the distance between your subject and the background. Shooting with my iPhone this way is the closest my phone has ever felt to a dedicated camera, and attaching the T-series lenses is super easy just by simply twisting and locking into place on your camera case. So how do the RAW files from a non-Pro iPhone using the Pro Camera app compare with the native RAW files from an iPhone 14 Pro? Well, I did that exact test, so you can see the differences. Let's take a look at some of these RAW files straight out of camera, and then with applying the exact same presets to each of the RAW files, using presets you can find in the Moment store. These images you're seeing compared here are all edited using my Lightroom presets, which you can find on the Moment store. There are 30 unique presets, all with low grain and high grain versions, in .xmp files and .dng files. They're compatible with Lightroom Classic, Lightroom CC, and Lightroom Mobile. As you can see, when we're applying the same preset to either the Apple Pro RAW from the iPhone 14 Pro or the Pro Camera App RAW from the iPhone 16, the results are identical. If you like the images that you've seen in this video, remember you can go download the Pro Camera app in the App Store right now. And if you like the way these images have been edited, go check out my presets, which you can now find on the Moment store. We'll link those in the description below. And if you want to watch another Moment video, YouTube thinks you're going to love this one. I have no idea what it is, but apparently it's your new favorite video.